Dear students, in our regular class we have begun already electric charges and fields chapter. Electric charges and fields chapter already we have begun in our regular class. In that regular class we have completed electric charges part. In that electric charges part, what we have studied previously, once we recall them. In charges, what we studied earlier, once again we recall. Right, in charges, we have studied about the charge. What is the charge? We have studied already. Charge is nothing but that is the property on a body which causes electrostatic force of attraction or repulsion nearby another charged body. And thereafter, we have studied charge is a scalar quantity. Its SI unit is nothing but coulomb. Afterwards, we have studied about the properties of charges. In those properties, mainly three properties we have studied. Charges are additive in nature. Charges are quantized. Charges are conserved. These three are the property of charges. In a similar way, there is another property of charges also we have studied. That is nothing but light charges are attract with each other, repel with each other. Unlike charges are attract with each other. That means light charges. That means there are two negative charges are there. Means this is one negative charge and this one is nothing but another negative charge. These two charges are repel with each other. Suppose if you take one is positive charge, other one is positive charge. Then two positive, that means light charges. Light charges are repel with each other. That means in between two light charges, repulsive force will be exist. Suppose if you take unlike charge, one is nothing but plus, another one is nothing but minus. That means one is positive charge, other one is negative charge, or one is negative charge, other one is positive charge. If you take it like this, means in that case, in between these two charges, what type of force will be exist, means attractive force will be exist. And thereafter, in this chapter only we have studied about the Coulomb's law. Coulomb's law, we have derived the expression for electrostatic force of electrostatic force expression we have derived. That is nothing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 divided by r square. Until this we have studied in our regular class. Now right now in present class we are going to discuss about the some other topic. The topic is nothing but electric field. Electric charges we have completed. Right now we are going to discuss with the electric field. In this electric field, let me go to the definition of the electric field. What is the electric field? Electric field is nothing but field. Field means some space. Field means some space. That means if you take a positive charge like this, now this is a charge, whether it is positive charge or negative charge. Now around this charge, until some space, the space which is responsible for electrostatic force, now that space is called here electric field. Now this charge we have taken until in this charge, around this charge, until this space, that means certain space I am considering, within this place, if you take a unit positive charge, this is the unit positive charge I am taking. Unit positive charge I am taking outside of the field. Now this is the completely field I am considering. Outside of the field, suppose if you take unit positive charge, in that case this unit positive charge did not experienced any kind of force. Suppose if this unit positive charge, if you take inside the field, that means if you bring inside the field, immediately this unit positive charge experiences the force. That means this charge capital Q is exert a force on Q naught. Capital Q is here source charge and Q naught is test charge. That means source charge means the charge which produce the electric field around it. Test charge is nothing but the charge which test whether the existence of, there is a existence of electric field or not. Now this is this space, the space around the charge is nothing but here electric field. That means within the field, if the charge is experiencing the force, then there is a existence of the field. Suppose if the charge is, test charge is not experiencing the force, then there is a no existence of electric field. This what, okay, I wanted to tell. That means here electric field is nothing but the space in which a unit positive test charge experiences the force. Once again, you just to come to here, electric field due to a charge, that means capital Q charge we have to take here. Electric field due to a charge at any point in space is defined as force experienced by the unit positive charge. That means electric field, mathematically how we have to tell, electric field is denoted by a letter E. Electric field E equal to force per charge, we can write force per charge. That means electric field equal to formula is nothing but force by charge, we can write. That means electric field is nothing but here force experienced by a unit positive charge. Okay, that is called here electric field. Right. Now thereafter, sir, electric field, what type of physical quantity? Electric field, okay, is a vector quantity. Electric field is a vector quantity. That means electric field is having both magnitude as well as direction. Because of that, here electric field we are considering as a vector quantity. And afterwards, what is the SI unit of electric field? SI unit of electric field is nothing but, here electric field is there. Electric field is equal to, what is the formula? Electric field is nothing but here